Hey guys, thanks for looking at my video. Just a real quick shout out to Robert. I actually talked and hung out with him a little bit at the Las Vegas Grand Prix this last weekend. He was actually playing this deck in paper, a little bit different variation. He ran the Leeches, and then I didn't really like that card, so I made a few changes. I asked him if I could play the deck. He said I could. But yeah, the general gist of the deck is a Jund deck. The main thing is the fact that you run 20 lands. Well, there's a bunch of ways. We got, 8 different fetches to make sure we get the right colors. And then also for mana fixing, we got Arcum Astrolabe, which is replaces itself, and Abundant Growth. That's why we have mainly green forest for our basic lands. Between those two, we can mana fix to play all our cards. We also have a little bit of similar to Core Skyfisher, but in green with invasive species to bounce either Abundant Growth or Arcum's Astrolabe. So you get a little bit extra value off of those right there. We got two main deck duresses to make sure that a few of our spells can get cast, early discard, Heart and Soul of most Jund decks. Then we got four Scred, which are probably some of the best removal right now. Then we got four of Chainer's Edicts, which are also pretty good. It's good against Boggles, Mono White Heroic, even the blue-green Infect decks that have been going around lately. Satyr's Wayfinder, which puts cards like Chainer's Edict in the graveyard, and creatures in the graveyard we can fetch with Grapple in the past, as well as it also is basically a 2-mana plus 4-mana for Gurmag Angler. Gurmag Angler is our main win condition. So we have a couple different ways, especially with the fetch land, Stator Wildfire, to fill up the graveyard quickly for this. We got four of Blightning, more discard, as well as some direct damage for in Popper. And then we got two Snuff Outs, which is free kill spells against, maybe Affinity deck or the mono green aggro deck, a bunch of different options. And then I got two Thorn of the Black Rose for mid-range decks. Sideboard, we get three Pyroblasts, which are good against any blue or counter decks. We got three of Pulse of Marasa, which is good for mid-range matchups, aggressive matchups because it gains life. It's actually good in most matchups. We got two of Relics for Graveyard Hate for any of those graveyard shenanigans. We got two Gorilla Shamans for Affinity. Three of Electricity for go wide decks, and two more duresses. Again, this is not my deck. Lobert, like I said, he did the base of it. I just made a few changes, so I just want to make sure he gets that shout out. If you don't know who Lobert is, if you just look up Lobert, he's a pretty big Popper player. He doesn't post as many videos, but he does. His videos are usually better quality. More edited than mine is. I kind of put it all together and put it out there so I can get you guys regular content. But that's the deck. If you guys have not done so far, could you please go down and like the video? It helps out with Google's algorithm to get me suggested to more people, as well as if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. I post 2 or 3 Popper decks a week, as well as I'm going to start posting some Arena standard decks pretty soon here too. Thank you very much, and I'll see you guys in match one. Welcome to match one. What we got here? Okay. This hand's capable. Go get a green, have Abundant Growth to get the red if we need it. Yeah, we're fine. We'll keep this. Yildol. Play this. Gonna go get a forest, Satyr Wayfinder. Probably Boros is what I'm guessing, but it could be Mono White Heroic as well. are we doing? Yield until the end step. Alright, is he just gonna time out? Is that how we're gonna win? This is not very... Alright, so we are gonna change our course. We're not gonna play this. I think we're just gonna chain his edict. Or he gets another creature out there. Chain his edict. Pass turn. Okay, we go this, get forest, play this, we're gonna go get red next, team sign with me. Build it on the end step. Take six. Red. Lightning. Cancel. What do we get in our sideboard for this matchup? That's the question. Damn. Okay. You got nine or a graveyard. That would put us up to 12. 13. Okay. See if that buys us, if that saves us a turn. Land or creature, what would save us? Any gain life? Do I have anything that gains life at this point? Looking for a Skred off the top. How many have I exiled? Two. Okay, so we're looking Skred or Snuff Out off the top. That's neither. I think we're dead. Okay. So we want dresses. And I think we want two pulses over grapple to gain life. Take out the those and I think we run it like that. We just didn't draw our targeted removal, which kind of sucks. Yes, I would like to play first. I will keep. Spread anything? Nope. Starting to get annoyed by this, to be honest. Yield until here on my turn. Okay. I do not want to draw lands, so I'm going to try to limit the amount of lands that I have. Take that. Okay, did not draw a line technically, so. Ooh, duress. I like duress. Black. Dress, dress, dress. That black. Scred. Play this. And attack for two. Kind of bullshit, like what the I need snuff out off the top. Invasive Species. I like being able to draw an extra card next turn. Maybe that's the wrong move, but that's the move I'm doing. Casey gives it protection from black. I mean, green. Chump block. Basically, it's snuff out or draw a die. So we got two snuff outs, three screds, two more Chainer's Edicts. Blightnings wouldn't be a bad draw either. Not drawing any of this shit though. We just gotta hope that he doesn't. Next turn, we can. Oh, fuck. I fucked that up. I should just. I'm being retarded. Could have flashback one and then done both. So he's got two turns to draw another creature. I'm being so dumb. God damn it. And you drew in it right away. God damn it. We need a top deck. Snuff Out, Scred, or Chainer's Edict. It's basically, like, that's the only way we survive. Okay, there you go. Rest them. Take that. Scred. Okay. Another Scred, I like that. Sure. No reason to attack, he can just block and prevent combat damage. It's gonna fucking slow us down a lot. We need another one. Okay, so we got four lands left, and then we got... Do we have another pulse? We have one more pulse, so that's what we're looking for, is that pulse. Just chain his edict now, see which one he keeps. Yep. All right. Perfect. That's actually might be the best draw we could have gotten. Lightning them. Gotta worry about time now. Pulse, go get Gurmag Angler. Turn clock for them. And we kill him next turn. Okay. I think I want one more pulse and take out a Blightning. We'll add one more of these and take out a Satyr. We'll see how that works. Okay, I like this hand. We will take Hyena Umbra. Okay. Merge unscathed. Okay. We will go Abundant Growth this. Spread that. And we're gonna keep Snuff Out up. play that. Pass turn. Okay. Yeah, alright. I'll see you guys in match 2. Yes, I would like to go first. Welcome to match 2, by the way, guys. Sure. I'll keep this. Alright, we're playing against a bunch of those, Mono White Heroic decks. Snuff Out's such a beautiful card. Kill that card. Go lightning. Make them discard two more. Discarded two lands. All right. Okay. That is annoying. Do not like that. Scred this guy. Chainer's Edict. And I think that should put the game in our favor. Then, pass turn. Okay. I will go tap, tap, tap. Play this guy, leaving Chainer's Edict. Yep. Play this guy, bounce this guy, play that. Land. Come on. All right, well, we're playing this. We're gonna try to take a land. Hopefully we find a land. If not, Gurmag Angler can be cast pretty easily next turn. I would like a land. Okay. Play land. Pass turn. Oh, block there. Hit me for six. Sure. Did he draw a card? No? Okay. Lorne of the Black Rose. We're gonna win this game pretty steadily now, I think. Sure. Abundant Growth. Seder. Take Ash Barrens. Gurmag Angler, land, grapple, lightning, black. Swinging for five. Another black. Pass turn. Bunny growth is fine. Lightning. Well, he's pretty much out of cards. We're just gonna scred this guy. And I think that Blightning guarantees a victory. Okay. So we definitely want Duresses again. And Pulses again. Shave these. Shave one of these. Shave one of these. Shave one grapple. I'm gonna try it like that again. Thank you. Okay. Keep. Sure. The rest. Go get forest. Get rid of their last cards. If you want to use Merge on Scathe, that's fine. Okay, both of them are no longer there. I mean, it doesn't. Literally did not change anything. And that buys us time. Okay. Okay. We're hella looking for a Gurmag Angler. I wanna. That's why we're using those. Just trying to find one to play, but. We could have gotten it back with Pulse. There we go. That's what we want. Doom, doom, doom. Doom, doom. Thank you. Okay. So a scred, no, not a scred. Snuff out is what we're looking for. Okay. I'm okay with killing that guy. Black, Scred, Satyr Wayfarer, Snuff Out, Duress, Lightning. All right, I just want to increase my life total because I want to use Chainer's Edict next turn. So we're just going to go get Invasive Species. And the next turn we can use Chainer's Edict. I'll pick one of these and then we'll double swing and then the turn after that we should have lethal. Well, now we have Blightning and. So we'll use Blightning first. Now he has to sacrifice his big creature. Else he just dies right now. Oh, he's dumb. You're dead. Okay. I'll see you guys in match three. All right, welcome to match three. Yes, I would like to go first. Let's see what we get here. Duress and Scred and Blightning. I like this hand. We will keep. See what we're playing against. We are playing against Affinity. Huh. Okay. Well, we will go fetch for, I think, a forest. I like fetching for a forest. Okay. Okay. We will go for Blightning. Let's see what he discards. Alrighty. Please, no creature. Okay. Scrud, make him sacrifice 2. Invasive species. Return a forest. Pass turn. Him getting 2 thought casts kind of screws me, to be honest. Yeah, whatever. I'm gonna block if he attacks. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna play Thorn of the Black Rose. And then we have Snuff Out up. He has a Galvanic Blast that's gonna suck, but it is what it is. Yep, that's annoying. Luckily, like I said, we have this Snuff Out. I'm on just regular block. Because we can play Gurmag Angler next turn. Can we play? We cannot play 2 Gurmag Anglers, but we can play 1. We can keep up everything else at least. If we can win game 1, that's actually going to be really good for us. Let's see if he goes for it. dual tank Gurmag Angler. Okay. That should be game, I think. Still, I think that should be game. Like, we're pretty far ahead. Chainer's egg's pretty sweet, too. Chainer's Edict. He's gonna what, fling it at us? Sure. Doesn't really do anything, but... GG's, bro. Okay, so we definitely want Gorilla Shamans, Duresses, Pulses. Thorn of the Black Rose is usually not that great. I think Grapple's a little worse than Pulse. Then I don't think Blightning's very good in this matchup. Yeah, this is fine. We'll keep. We're gonna go green first, I would say. No, we'll go green probably first. Yeah, that's not a huge deal. Like, I would like an untapped land though. Yeah. Chainer's Edict, sure. Relics, okay. I mean, that's a very interesting, thing. All right, let's go Duress. Really want a land so we can kill this guy. We can Duress him. Actually, we don't even need a land. We can just use this. Yeah, we're probably dead. God damn it. Just need a land. That technically counts. No, it doesn't. It doesn't even count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I needed a fucking untapped land because then we could have played Archimage to the Lobe and kill this fucking piece of shit. And then we could have blocked there. I think we just play the fucking Gurmag now then. He has it. If he like top decks it, you top deck it. I'm not, Come on, fucking lands. There we go. Six, seven, seven. Okay, seven damage there. He attacks with just the Atog. I'm actually gonna block with the Gurmag Angler this time. Yeah, he got there. It happens. I think we're fine, and just we weren't drawing any lands, and we were again not being able to progress our board. Yes, I would like to play first. Mulligan. This hand is great. We will keep. We will get rid of one of these. Done. Black. Green, play these, take a Ash Barons. Okay. Land. Gorilla Shaman. Destroy this piece of shit. Destroy that piece of shit. Swing for one. Hydro Blast? Sure. It is what it is, bro. And now we're gonna cast our Gurmag Angler. Feel pretty good about it. We will be taking Thought Cast, play a land, attack, dude, you already see the Chainer's Edict in the graveyard. Like, you're about to get fucked. Get rid of Screed. That is game. He just doesn't realize it yet. That's game. Sure. Alrighty. So I'll see you guys in match 4. We're playing with house money at this point. Welcome to match 4. Yes, I'd like to play first. 10 seems good. We'll keep. We'll go land, we'll go Satyr. Take a mountain, I guess. Searing Blades, sure. But I'm 15, no, 17, okay. Play Evasive Species. he's all like probably thinking like, what am I playing against? What is this garbage? And I'll be like, it's Jund, bro. Just Jundum. 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 Yeah, yeah. Never seen evasive speeches in his life before. He's probably like, what is this shit? But like, it's the best deck ever. Maybe not the best deck, but it is sure a lot of fun. Yeah, that definitely happens. That was hella rude. I would appreciate you not doing that to me ever again. Okay. Nope. We would like to not die. I think we're gonna make him discard his last two, though. That's what we do, right? Make him discard him. Hope lightning probably save us 6 life. Go down to 8. 8, then 6, then I had a win from there. Ooh, gee. What is he waiting for? Go get a black. Play the black. Lightning them. Make them discard their 2 last cards. Yep. We're gonna go down to 6. We're probably dead. I don't think we can race that now. Now we can. Want him to draw just lands and creatures for the next couple turns. No direct damage spells. I think that puts game out of reach, though. That's game. Okay. So pulses, duresses. Don't think we want snuff outs. Pulse is better than grapple. So I think we're gonna take those out. Take out 1 Thorn of the Black Rose. We're going to try like that. Yes, we would like to play first. I'll keep this. Okay, dude. What the fuck? Swamp, duress. Don't like Searing Blaze. Go get red, play red. Scred this guy. Funding growth, the red land. Swing for one. Abundant growth. Scred, duress, duress, pulse, ash barons, satyr. I really need a pulse. Okay. Needs to draw lands. Okay. All right. Thank you. Creature, land, Searing Blaze. Maybe not even Searing Blaze. But creature or land, I think we win this game and we can force a game three. Creature or land. That's what I need him to draw. And he scooped. Okay. Yeah, we run it the same way. Well, we're gonna mulligan. This is easy mulligan. Mulligan again. Alright, well, we gotta try to keep this. We will get rid of this. And that. Okay, have a spell heavy hand, not a... Okay, cool. No creatures. Please, no creatures. I need time. Please draw freaking land. Thank God. Alright, we're gonna live the dream, guys. We're gonna live the dream. He kept a hand he should have not kept. Oh. Oh, God. Take that. Thank you very much. Beautiful. Mwah. Oh, I'm so grateful for this. Okay. Well, that's scary. But, land. Invasive species. Bring this back. Hope we're not dead. Oh, I would have loved to land. Land? Nope, okay. I'm gonna go Seder Wayfinder. Land, okay. We're probably dead. Mulliganing to 5 sucks, dude. Yeah, we lost. Alright, see you guys in match 5. Alright. Hand seems pretty good. Keep. Okay. Let's see if they try to go for the turn 2 win. If so, Snuff Out's gonna be hilarious. Have him having like 4 mutagen growth or something like that, that'd be hilarious. Yep. Take one, sure. Okay. Well, in that case, we're gonna pay for and kill this guy. We're gonna cycle. We'll get red mana. Have that. Scred him. He has mutagen growth. He has mutagen growth. He does not. We are in the golden age now. You can add now, buddy. Sure. A lot more infect players. What's he doing? Okay, come on, buddy. Let's do something. Chop, chop. Okay, what is he doing? Hello? He lost connection. Okay, that makes sense now. How many minutes until he drops? Hopefully he comes back pretty quickly here. My apologies, guys. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Gundam, there we go. Okay. I'm just gonna lightning him and force him to top deck. Okay. Forest, abundant growth on a swamp, Gurmag Angler, tap, exile, 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 exile one of those satyrs, keep up two spreads, swing for one. And then he's gonna be on a 3-turn clock from this point on. Okay. Abundant growth on the other one. Playland. Pass turn. We're going to duress, see what he has in hand first. Scred this guy in response. Attack. Sure. Sure. When he goes to regenerate, that's when we'll scred him. Scred. And lightning them for the kill. Okay, so we definitely want to not have thorns. We want duresses. Do I want electricity over anything? Shave 2 blightnings, add 2 electricities. Like that. Go like that. Yeah, I think we should be fine. I'll keep. Okay. All right, let's see if he goes for the kill. Nope, he did not go for the kill. Alright, so we're gonna go get black. We're gonna go get a green. We're gonna see what we can draw. That makes me feel a lot safer. Funding growth. Duress right now. Take spell pierce. I will take three if that's all he's doing. In response, Scred. In response to that, snuff out. Okay, ponder, sure. I would like to draw electric green now, actually. Come on, electricity. That Scred's pretty good. We can block this guy for a while, so we're gonna just Scred this guy and then basically try to outdraw him. Nope. Sure. Not a huge deal. Block. Black, green, green. We'll swing with this one because it'll cause more damage. We'll keep blocking with this one. Block. Sure. Good Gurmag Angler, okay. Swing for 5. Still gonna block. Sure. Damn, he probably got it. Fuck. Alright, Blightning wins the game for us. Any sort of removal is good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if we get a land and put... Fuck. We needed an untap land. Well, we're gonna double block and then use Chainer's Edict next turn. Any sort of pump kills us. Down to 6. So he's got 2 turns basically. To find a creature. Alright. Not so bad, not too bad actually. 4-1. Yeah, that was actually pretty good. Let's see what we win. We got hella points. Got new Aramesa. Okay, coat of arms. Yeah, cool. Not terrible at all. I'm okay with this. Yeah, those points are really nice too, because it helps us not have to spend anything on the Pauper League when we play in a few days. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.